Good morning and welcome to Thursday's Thoughts for the Day. Last week was the 35th anniversary of something unique. It was a year before I was born. That event was Live Aid. Live Aid was a benefit concert held on Saturday the 13th of July 1985. As well as the ongoing music-based fundraising initiative, the original event was organised by Bob Geldof and Midge Ure to raise funds for relief on the ongoing Ethiopian famine. This was held at two events, held at Wembley Stadium, London, with 72,000 people, and the John F. Kennedy Stadium, Philadelphia, with 89,400 people. The 1985 Live Aid concert was a follow-on from the successful charity single Do They Know It's Christmas. In October 1984, images of hundreds of thousands of people starving to death in Ethiopia were shown in the UK in Michael Burke's BBC News reports on the 1984 famine. This led to one of the most successful concerts in history, with performers such as Status Quo, Adam Ant, Paul Young, Queen, The Who, U2, David Bowie, Elton John, Paul McCartney, and many more. What a fantastic lineup it was, and that was only the UK. For the US had stars like Led Zeppelin having a reunion. Phil Collins appeared at both concerts in London and Philadelphia, thanks to being able to fly on Concorde. 1 billion viewers in 110 countries watched the live broadcast, thanks to 13 satellites, and £40 million was raised. The world was united. People was connected. The main act was Queen, who performed for 21 minutes. The performance was incredible, and Freddie Mercury owned the stage. And the song, Radio Gaga, with 72,000 people in the old Wembley Stadium raising their hands, looked incredible. It was that good it felt that I was even there. Queen at first wasn't going to do the performance, but after 21 minutes of pure entertainment, the donations went up. And Elton John, who was next following, he had to follow that and said thanks or words to that effect. And later on, Freddie Mercury and Brian May performed a song called Is This the World We Created? The words say, Is this the world we created? What did we do it for? Is this the world we invaded? Against the law. So it seems in the end, is this what we're all living for today? The world that we created. You know that every day a helpless child is born who needs some loving care inside a happy home. Somewhere a wealthy man is sitting on his throne, waiting for life to go by. This was 35 years ago, but still, there is so much need in the world. Have we, humanity, really learnt? And is this the world we created? The most vulnerable countries in the world are affected and will be affected after COVID-19. and in this country, almost 2,500 children admitted to hospitals in England suffering malnutrition in 2020. People at the beginning of the lockdown are saying how much it's nice in March to say we can hear the birds. But our roads have soon become busy again. Have we really learnt in a world that God created? The song goes on to say, is this the world we created? We made it all our own. Is this the world we've devastated right to the bone? If there's a God in the sky looking down, what can he think of what we've done to the world that he created? On Monday, Stephen, in his thought for the day, reminded us the importance of reconnecting with God. And I think that God also wants us to reconnect with the reality of the world, to be connected with the most vulnerable people. Like the song Radio Gaga says, not to be some background noise. And I think there's some truth in that. For we are called to be instruments of change. For our music of love is to be played so that the most vulnerable can hear, to speak out. And as Rupert reminded us yesterday, we shouldn't forget our stand. Robert also said on Tuesday that we are a living temple of God. And when we think of the most vulnerable people in the world, let's go in, dip into our Bibles. Jesus reminds us in the Gospel of Matthew that when we welcome the stranger, we did it for him. This is what Jesus says in Matthew 25. For I was hungry, and you gave me nothing to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me nothing to drink. I was a stranger, and you did not invite me in. I needed clothes, and you did not clothe me. I was ill and in prison, and you did not look after me. They also will answer, Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or needing clothes or ill or in prison and did not help you? He will reply, truly I tell you, whatever you did not to do for the one of the least of these, you did not do for me. Then they will go away to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life. 35 years ago, people stepped out and made a difference. People were connected all over the world to join in with the music. And as a living temple of God, we are all called to do the same. Let us pray. Creator God, you loved the world into life. Forgive us when our dreams of the future are shaped by anything other than glimpses of a kingdom of justice, peace, and an end to poverty. Incarnate God, you taught us to speak out for what is right, Make us content with nothing less than a world that is transformed into the shape of love, where poverty shall be no more. Breath of God, let there be abundant life. Inspire us with the vision of poverty over and give us the faith, courage, and will do to make it happen. We thank you, God, that you are a creator God who created the world through love. So may we return that love to speak up for your people and not to be some background noise. Amen.
Is this the world we devastated? Right.